Hello, my dear class 10 children. How are you all? I hope you all are fine and enjoying the holidays and completing my maths work with full enthusiasm and interest. In case of doubt, you can contact me on my WhatsApp. You will not be disappointed from my side. I will try my level best to clear your doubts. You need to first have a pick of that question, have a click, mention the question number and send it through WhatsApp. I try my level best to solve maximum questions of your exercise and send it to you in the form of PDF. Since it takes much time, that's why my dear students, I don't solve every question of the exercise. It takes a lot of time. I sit and solve it using my laptop. It takes a lot of time. You have to complete the exercise in your copy. Keep completing. I am going to begin today a new topic, and that is progression, series. In your book, it is named by progression. Series or progression. Series of numbers. So we can have many series based on a certain pattern. If we see that numbers are arranged on the basis of a definite pattern, we say that we have a series of numbers. The pattern of writing the number is like this. Now, you might have seen in the paper, newspaper and other things, what will be the next number to the series. So what you do? You just guess out that, the difference is 2. Therefore, after this, the next number will be this. Every alphabet of the series written have a difference of 2. Therefore, after this alphabet, the next chance to come the alphabet is this one. So what we see? We just find out the pattern of writing the numbers or alphabets. In the same way, we will be given 2 types of series based on 2 types of pattern. The first series is called arithmetic series or arithmetic progression. Arithmetic series or arithmetic series or arithmetic progression. In short, we name it as AP, AS, anything, AP or AS. So, how do we consider the numbers in this type of progression? Let me make it clear. If we write or arrange numbers in such a way that the difference between 2 consecutive numbers remains common. I mean, let us consider a set of natural numbers, my dear students. A set of natural numbers. Do you know that the difference between 2 consecutive natural numbers is 1? Yes, I think everybody knows. So what we see, if we have the set of natural numbers, we write it as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and so on. So what is the difference between two? It's two consecutive numbers. 1, here 1, here 1. I write another set of numbers, odd numbers. Odd, 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, thus. What is the difference between its two consecutive terms? 2, na? So here, when we see that we have a series of numbers in such a way that the difference between its two consecutive numbers remains constant. So here the difference is 2, no? Here the difference between two consecutive numbers is 1. So if we have such a series that the difference between its two consecutive terms remains common, then that series is called arithmetic series. I repeat, if we see that we have a series of numbers such that the difference between its two consecutive terms remains common. Here, the difference is 2, which is common to the two consecutive numbers. Therefore, this series will be called arithmetic series. Another example. Another. 1, 5, 9, 13. What you observe? My dear students, you observe that the difference is 4. Here you see 5 minus 1, 4, 9 minus 5, 4, 13 minus 9, 4. So this series will be called arithmetic series. Because the difference is common. Difference means difference between its two consecutive terms. So this series is arithmetic series. But to solve the questions of the exercise, we need to understand this arithmetic progression using the symbols. So my dear students, this is this one. I have written here 1, huh? This is considered as the first term. And the symbol for this we use as A, small a. Then the next term we show by the symbol A plus D, where D is the difference. Then next will be D more to this, A plus 2D, A plus 3D, A plus 4D and so on. I have written a series. You can see the difference between two numbers. You can find out by doing subtraction. Here is D. So A is the first term. And D is the common difference. D is the common difference. One more set of symbols we use to show a series, to write a arithmetic series. That is T1, T2, T3, T4 and so on. Please look at this. T1 stands for A. T2 stands for A plus D. T3 stands for A plus 2D. I would like to make it clear. T1 stands for A. T2 means second term. A plus D. T3, A plus 2D. T4, A plus 3D. One more thing, please see here. If it is T4, fourth term, then we write here 3D. If there will be fifth term, we will write here 4D. If seventh term, we will write here 6D. Therefore, nth term, Tn, we will write by this formula, A plus n minus 1 into t. Here it is 4, then 3. If it is m, then it will be 1 less than n, n minus 1 a. So this is the formula for the last term or nth term of an AP. This is the formula Tn. Tn is the symbol for nth term. Tn is the symbol for nth term. A, first term. And D, common difference. How do we get common difference? To get the common difference in an AP, we need to do the subtraction of its two conjugate. We need to get the subtraction of this from this one. So 3 minus 5 minus 3, 3 minus 2, 9 minus 5, 13 minus 9. This will give you D. Now, A plus 2D minus A plus D will give you common difference D. So, T4 minus T3 will give you D. Remember, if you subtract a term from the next term of a series, you will get the common difference. In an AP, to get the common difference, what do we do? We subtract a term from the next term. So this is the formula for nth term of a series. Questions we will do in the next exercise. Thank you.